the world demands of halal products, covering foods, services, and other products will continue to grow with the increase in global population, especially the Muslim. Awareness of the needs and importance of halal products and services have also increased. The halal industry is a new growth sector in the Malaysian's manufacturing sector and is the fastest growing global business across the world.
Assalamualaikum,
my name is Anis, so I opening cafe soon. So may I ask,
any requirement for halal certification?
Waalaikumsalam, Miss Anis. My name is Aiman. So there are a lot of requirements for halal certification, and it can be divided into a few elements or branches, namely requirements of raw materials, the ingredients and processing aid, the processing and packaging and labeling as well, for the factories, the food premises, and many more. So basically, before we discuss this in depth, why don't we join other applicants with the other officers as well in a meeting room?
Yeah.
Alright, welcome. Alright, Anis, these are my two officers.
Yeah. Assalamualaikum everyone, I'm Irfan Akil. We will be helping you assist you regarding the halal certificate. Any kind of question you can ask us, and we'll be helping you as much as we can.
Waalaikumsalam, saya Ifrain. So, I need to know about the procedure about requirement for raw material for my cafe. So, what the procedure and requirement for the material ingredients and also the processing aids?
Alright, for requirements of raw materials and also ingredients, the safety and halal source of the ingredients must be ensured. And any ingredients that derive from animals must have halal certificate. And those without halal certificate shall be accompanied with complete specifications like its compositions and also sources.
Assalamualaikum, I'm Luqman. So I'm here to talk about, I mean to ask about the processing requirement by Jakim. So can any officer explain it to me?
Okay Luqman, let me briefly explain to you. As for the processing, any kind of product should be produced consistently actually with updated production record. And also during preparation, like handling, processing, packaging, storage or transfer of products, they shall be in the compliance to requirement by Sharia law and remain clean as well as comply to good manufacturing practices, good hygiene practices. And also other than that, you should not mix halal raw material and products with non-halal or uncertain halal status material or sources. Also, halal products should be transported with halal products only. That's the important one.
I'm Shamimi and I want to ask the regarding packaging and labeling. So what the requirement of the packaging and labeling?
Now, every packaging label should be printed prominently and clearly. So the packaging label as well shall contain information, namely the name of the product, the Malaysian halal logo with Malaysian standard number as well, the list of ingredients and expiry date, and many more.
Oh, I see, like that. Thanks for the explanation, Mr. Akil, Mr. Akila, and Mr. Aiman.
That is not all. There are also other requirements like food premise requirements. And under this requirement, the applicants must ensure that equipment used shall be free from najis, does not contain any hazardous materials and results in side effects to the product produced. Liquor and materials sourced from liquor is strictly prohibited to be in the halal kitchen and hotel, including the storage area.
So guys, any further information that you guys want to know will be provided in our manual procedure for Malaysian Halal Certification. Thank you for your interest and cooperation.
Thank you.
To sum up, everything, Muslims are prohibited from consuming food products in their daily activities by their religious responsibilities. The main rules governing what is prohibited and authorized are given out in the Quran and Sunnah. What is outlined in the Quran and Sunnah, on the other hand, is very general. In effect, Muslims would have to make a new resolution every time a new type of food products and or production technique appear. The halal certification plays a role here. To the certification serves as a proof that the religious guidelines were followed. Fatwa resolution on various halal issues must be done on a regular basis as a guide to the halal certification authorities. Some of the fatwas given in relation to halal food have been compiled and rationalized in this page to create a large system. There must be a close relationship between fatwa and halal certification. Malaysia seeks to capitalize on its halal certification to gain a competitive edge in the halal market. There must be no question, no doubts about the system integrity. The system must not only meet domestic demands, but at the same time, it must also be strong enough to serve as a model for other countries to emulate.